But Chad and Mike will be coming forward. I'd like if you turn through your book to that page or to that tab. You will note the first page there is a SMART goals worksheet that the chairman referenced earlier. I'm encouraging you all to consider looking at these, and we try to put them, I think, approximately every tab remains, so that as you go through these, if you know an item that you feel is worthy of discussing when you set goals, and there's something you'd like to make note that it would be helpful, I think, to you rather than trying sometime tomorrow to go back and remember or think back about something that came up today or in the morning. So we will provide, we're providing these for you. There are extra ones, as the chairman has already discussed, either in the front or in the back of the book. And we will use those tomorrow afternoon. What Chad will be presenting for you is our current facilities priority list and those dates that we have anticipated for either the beginning of the project and the completion or some reference to that. Chad, as Harrison indicated earlier, is our liaison in dealing with all of these SPLOST projects for our construction with associated with the Sheriff's Department or Parks and Rec or anything else. Our project manager can handle all of those. And works with Harrison on the amount of funds that are available as SPLOST monies come in. So as you look through this, please note that this is a lot of these, y'all, those of you who were here last week, you may have seen this. We've changed some of the dates, but not a lot. But Chad will give you now an update on each of these projects.
Yes. As we start going through this, you know, the list is pretty much like it was last year with new anticipated dates. We have approximately 11 projects in SPLOST 7, with one of them being split up. Last year we had them together at the soccer complex in Maryland Field. Those are two separate projects. The total amount allocated towards all the facility projects is $9,708,500, which the breakdown is $1,630,833 a year, or $135,840.27 per month. And as Mr. Pritchard mentioned, the projects for the DLPRA are managed by the county and paid for out of SPLOST by Lowndes County and then turned over to the Parks and Rec Court. With the exception of this list, there's two projects which are being built at Freedom Park. And the way the house bill is 481?
489.
Is labeled, they will manage that project instead, so this is in the city limits. This is a staff recommended priority order. The Naylor boat ramp at $50,000. The Freedom Park basketball court, $50,000. Lowndes County Civic Center renovation, $150,000. Naylor Community Center, $250,000. Animal shelter renovation, $800,000. Library renovations, $1,582,000. Lowndes County Sheriff's Office, Evidence Storage Building, $250,000. Lowndes County Fire Risk Improvements and Drill Field and Training Facilities, $699,000. 911 expansion and security upgrade, $799,500. Courthouse renovations, $2 million. Soccer complex, $3 million. And Maryville Field, $150,000.
We have been working, Chad has, on the boat ramp. We have a cooperative and working with us on this project. Chad, can you describe how we will, what we will do first on this?
Yes. On the name of the program, we have a proposed engineering hiring for this month. It's on the agenda for next week. We had a proposal come in from a professional engineer, innovative engineer, with Bill Kent, for the boundary survey, topo design documents, and bid documents. Once that hopefully is approved, he will then move forward with the design of the actual boat ramp, the parking lot, the road going in, and then also 84, how we're going to build up the driveway. We'll get that completed as quickly as possible. The only issue we have in proceeding forward is the river needs to reach close to base flow. Last year it took me and DNR about 5 months of going back and forth just so they could get the study done to where the boat ramp location would need to be. We started early 2014, it was September, October. They came down twice to do the studies on for the location. So, I mean, we can go ahead and get the documents done, have all the everything ready to go out and bid it. We won't bid it as soon as the documents are done, because we can't bid a project in March and actually hold till the contract until September possibly, just because of price fluctuations and everything else. We can do a quick bid, a 30-day bid, advertise everything, and then get it out the door as soon as we see the rivers based on forecast we get some base flow. We have a real good idea of how everything's going to lay out down there. The acreage is going to be close to 5 acres, is what we will obtain from Dr. Rector. And I've met with Dr. Rector a number of times and talked with him on the phone with him.
He will donate the land.
Not at this point, no, sir. We have talked about Dr. Rector, and we went over the appraisal together. And Dr. Rector, I asked Dr. Rector, would he be willing, whatever he would be willing to do, what would you do? And he said, all right, get your numbers together, once we have a bunch of our numbers together. If this is a project and bust, because you sell them the land, okay. But if not, then we will negotiate the price. Fair market value is $5,600 due to the appraisal. But I've already talked about everything he's willing to negotiate.
How deep is that amount of water that you're saying?
At base flood, it's about 6 feet deep.
It's about 6 feet deep.
Yes, sir. The actual boat ramp location would be about 400 or 500 yards north, feet north of the road. There's a sandbar. You can see that the road would be just above that sandbar. That was the best location based on the criteria for the boat ramp.
Before we start going into each of the projects, Harrison, was there anything concerning the SPLOST monies that we've looked at that you need to comment on?
You mean in terms of the projected dollars?
Yes.
Well, as I already pointed out, and I talked to Chad yesterday about this, most of his projects are in that second half, which we have dedicated 100% of the revenue regardless of what the SPLOST revenues are doing. The group up top is the group that's being adjusted as we go through the SPLOST. I think there's only one item up there in the top, but it's not a large one.
I just want to make sure that y'all thank you. In looking at this, there are particular questions rather than us going through what each item consists of, and we can do that if you want, if you take as much time as you want. But are there particular different questions we, that we could go to initially to answer for anybody concerning the list of projects and the order in which we propose.
I only have one. So have we received an idea or a drawing of what the new courthouse is supposed to look like?
Not a proposal on what it is scheduled to look like. That will, excuse me, most likely the items that we begin with first, I think, were listed here in HVAC, door replacement, and general stabilization. You want to comment on what those,
yes,
whatever the space usage is, we believe it's going to be pretty much the same.
Yeah, let me, if I can, as y'all recall, Judge McLean and the Courthouse Preservation Committee have met. We have gotten that information back from him as far as what his recommendations are. We're probably going to take that, of course, and get Judge McLean to come and make a presentation for us on that to kind of go from there.
Let us know what you want to use.
Let us know what, well, let us know what his recommendations are. We still, at the end of the day, as a commission, we're going to have to determine what the future use of that facility is. And of course, a lot of that's going to then have to do with how you're going to renovate, what you're going to do with it, and then the $2 million budget that we currently have, how far is that going to go and what the limitations are going to be, which to me, I think is minimal.
That's right. Being the nature of the project and the historic nature and everything we would have to do, $2 million is going to get beat up real quick. Just to stabilize the existing features and HVAC, $2 million will go pretty quick as far as money goes.
I think the bill for AC last year was $34,000 for the AC bill, right?
You're talking about for
right, utility.
And that was for running the AC.
That's right. Yeah.
And that was with nobody in there.
That's right.
Because it had to stay at a certain temperature.
That's right. Center, right. That's right. To keep the building stabilized.
And so the new system.
What staff would like to do, if they see one of the wishes as far as what staff would want to do with $2 million, is to get a proper system in the building. Right now, the system they have works, but it's not a proper system, commercial type system for the building. To get a proper system, you can, just like any other new building commercially, you can cool this area, heat this area, and it runs more efficient. Right now, it's running on several units that sit outside the building in the white fence on the back side. And, you know, they were just installed over years and years, you know, as far as to fit the needs of the building. And it's working, but it needs the proper commercial type HVAC system to fit the building.
The final restoration plan is to restore the back side originally?
Yes, sir. That is, as far as the back side, we've got the pictures, and it's not far from looking like the picture I've seen looking like what it used to look. But it's all going to depend on money, the usage of what the commission decides. I mean,
part of that work, you know, was air cold sheet and things like that. So obviously we would not kind of bring it back. And once that was opened up for the connector to the annex, there was a large hole there. And the idea has been, how would we restore that to some architectural degree that it still looks pleasant as far as the building is concerned and useful. So most likely it's going to be putting some type of glass in there. It's probably going to be the most economical way to look at that as opposed to trying to come back and match brick, et cetera, et cetera. close that. As far as that, that's concerned, really that first part is probably going to be just, the first part of it is just going to be to make as much of the interior on probably that first floor usable. It may be more than that, but I'm guessing it's going to take about $2 million just to do that. Is that correct?
I would say the time to get done with the HVAC, hopefully, and then getting the usage correct for the first floor, you will be rid of $2 million.
Going back to the recommended priority order and the project list itself, I don't think that anybody that's here is sitting on the commission staff. When this was generated, there's not a single project in here that's not approved. Every one of these projects was determined that they were important and needed to be done for our community. And it does become very, very difficult to sit here and say which one should have this priority and move things up. Of course, a lot of this has to do with the timing and standpoint of being able just to get someone started with a plan with all the information needed to establish that plan, and at the same time as revenue comes in, do the same thing with it. So I think personally it looks like a good plan. I think the key to it is as we know that in the past, that if there becomes a need or something of where we have to make an adjustment to it, we should be able to do that. That's not to say we're going to jump all over and start making changes, but within the realms of those that criteria, we should be able to make an adjustment.
I think it's fair to say that each one of these items, Chad is working on to some degree on a regular basis. Obviously, some are more require more activity than the others. For instance, there's nothing really to do in the renovation right now except some leg work, paper work, etc. There's more activity taking place on the boat ramp, on the community center, on the soccer complex near Fairfield. All of those are requiring more time, but most everything has some part of it is being worked on. That you see, turn over a couple of pages, you'll see that the breakdown page up page six what is entailed there. That can be coming on those.
Yes, sir.
Buildings.
On the civic center, what I'm referring to is building D is a big building that sits sideways to the highway 84. Is going in and basically cosmetically renovating that building. That's new exterior wall panels and roof panels is needed. Several of them are rusting out. The paint, the coating on it has faded real bad. New lighting upgrades on the facility. Raised lettering on the exterior of the building, because right now there's nothing on the building. It's just looks like a butler building sitting out there. And new carpet for the showroom in the building, upgrades to the bathroom, concessions, and then also moving over to the 4-H offices at the end of it is cosmetically again, flooring, paint, new millwork, premium work panels, and then plastic cover out.
Any other questions on these?
I was just curious what the anticipated overall cost for American Field was. We're just making a contribution, correct?
That's correct.
And we're not going to make that contribution until they've got the rest of the funding needed to complete the project, right?
That's correct. Okay. Lowndes County will, as it's being put into the fund monthly, but from what I'm meeting with Parks and Rec, I believe the field, it's more build the miracle field along with its concession stand and bleachers. And then the other three fields will be not be built. The grass will be planted.
Right.
With their SPLOST money, they have another SPLOST money from the city or SPLOST money, regular money they have on their own. What I've been told, I think that's about $1.7 million altogether. And I think the miracle field is going to come where, somewhere around $500,000. Just to get it done.
So the architect will be selected soon, and then they'll go from there. I mean, it could be a long time before this is,
that's correct,
comes to fruition, right?
And meeting with them, and I know this for sure, we have $150,000, and I've been told by Mr. Page that they have another $100,000 already donated towards the miracle field, as well as some vendors of various types that have committed, you know, the materials.
But if they've got to grade and drain all the fields and all that has to be done up front, okay.
Yeah, because in order to make it work, the other three fields we have to go ahead and the infrastructure has to be done.
Anything else on our SPLOST projects? I just want to say, I know that we're all working as hard and diligently as we can. And of course, the revenue is set to close in, but the animal shelter is, if you could look at previous pictures and everything that you have there, there's a huge need there that needs to be, you know, addressed as soon as we can. We need to kind of follow up on that, and I would say there's some ongoing things from cooperation and working with the library, but also there's a huge need there as well.
Chad, can you tell what you did to the improvements at the animal shelter?
Yes, sir. We had some money left over in SPLOST 5 that was designated for the animal shelter. It wasn't a whole lot. We had one of the things we noted on the fact sheet here is that they needed some additional storage room space. So we, staff was able to go in. There's a current shelter out behind the animal shelter. It's a covered shelter. And it had a storage room built on it already. We went in and framed up two more storage rooms. And that helped with separating the cat and dog, cat litter and dog food and cat food storage. So part of that work was already done. And then we also, in doing that, we were able to spice up the existing covered shelter as far as siding and gutters, because we had some water penetration issues. The gutters up that, and we were able to get that money in our SPLOST 5 as well doing that.
One of the reasons why that's so important is that when we move forward with these innovations, we have to have somewhere to put the animals while we're moving some medical work. Department of Agriculture has three strict rules on when the animals can be around freshly painted walls and floors and things like that. So this will also, we were able to recycle some independent storage buildings from public works. So we've got room to move what's in storage, the independent storage buildings, and then get those animals in a controlled environment with what's currently the storage area when we can start working on the inside of the shelter. So those plans have already been laid in conjunction.
Those rooms have what we call RFP panels, which is reinforced plastic panels, which is what we probably anticipate when we're putting in more regular walls on the animal shelter itself. But it's very easy to be able to turn those, as Paige was saying, those rooms into temporary holding pens, you know, when we're in the existing shelter doing the work we need to do there.
As y'all know, Chad is assigned to the engineering department. Mike is responsible as the engineer for that department. While Chad acts somewhat independently on working on the projects, he works with
Mike on any of those that relate to the engineering, that relate to dealing with architects, et cetera, et cetera. So I don't want y'all to think that we are not utilizing the services of the engineer to the maximum as far as these projects are concerned. So Mike, you guys have comments on any of these that you think that you see that you want to comment on?
No, sir. We're working, like Mr. Taylor said, we're working with Innovate on the native boat ramp. So that's, we're going to have that on the commission agenda a couple of weeks, or next week. And Native Community Center, we've done some, she has done some preliminary layouts on how we're going to park unit, working on driveways, how we can work those things.
Can we get a little bit of an update on where we're at with the proposed soccer complex?
Yes, sir.
And for that part.
We've been working on the soccer complex for quite a while, actually. Once, first regarding money, we received a deed from the DOT for the land. There is a reversion clause in that deed. So right now, the county attorney, as well as the DLPRA attorney, for your motion, is working through some kind of agreement so we don't activate the reversion clause when we turn the park over to the Parks and Rec
Department. That property is coming to us from the Department of Transportation.
And Joe, this is the AI, right?
That's correct.
It's on the AI. It's
just adjacent to the old rest area. Kind of circles that and then to the north.
76 acres, should be 69.
So that is being deeded to the county with that reversion for us to turn it over to Parks and Rec. That could trigger that reversion. DOT doesn't want that. We don't want that. Parks and Rec doesn't want it. So it's a combination of the attorneys for all three of those entities trying to make sure that they do what everybody wants and expects. It's just taking a little bit of wordsmithing, as we've been told.
We just don't want in 20 years when none of us are here to it trigger in on somebody, some new people that might be around this year. But getting back to the actual soccer complex, once we started receiving, then we were going to get the land. We had Lowndes and Associates go ahead and lay out four concepts for the whole 69 acres with the help of Lowndes and VLPRA. We narrowed it down to one final concept plan. That final concept design was approved by the Parks and Rec Authority, their building committee and authority. And then Lowndes put together a projected cost for the whole facility. And of course, the whole facility included soccer complex, baseball, softball complex, recreation center complex. Our phase is going to be the soccer complex. He projected cost on that, and then right now, BLPRA and myself are going through those costs to make sure we're in budget with the SPLOST costs. We currently have about $2.5 million in SPLOST 6 that was designated for Parks and Rec, and then $3 million in SPLOST 7. So we can go ahead and get started. As soon as everything's cleared up the land, the design's going to go pretty fast. And then we can go ahead, since we have the $2.5 million in SPLOST 6 in the bank right now, we can move forward to the project.
One of the first things that we're planning on doing, nothing will be built up there lately, is the bathrooms. They're basically shut down to use porta potties. So they're at the existing skate park now. The pumps inside the lift station have gone bad. So you're talking $75,000, $80,000 to replace the pumps in the pump station, the lift station, to pump it back up. So one of the first things that will be done is there's going to be a new lift station set at the far north end, and that's going to pump up to this one. That'll be used as a holding tank to pump up
Does anybody know exactly where this property?
No, I was gonna ask, how do you get to this?
You go up Interstate 75, turn left on 122, and the Hay Hour Business Park.
Right.
Mike Lumber used to have a store there up there. You go down that road, and then at the end, it makes a right, goes into the skate park.
Okay, so you go into that industrial park?
That's right.
To the end of that?
Take a right.
I think that actually is the North Lowndes Recreation Park.
That's correct.
Is what it actually is.
They're, and back there currently, a multi-purpose field, there's some baseball, football, soccer, and a skate park, a pavilion, and then concession restaurant, some parking.
Playground and football.
There's, yes, I was putting in last year.
A pavilion.
Pavilion. And as far as the soccer complex, what staff is laid out right now is an eight-field complex, which can be used for soccer, football, and possibly lacrosse.
But soccer, lacrosse?
Well, the reason we say that is because when most of us were coming along, I don't know that anybody who's played with soccer. Maybe.
You mean the one who do it?
Yeah.
Kick a ball.
It's closer to kickball than soccer. But lacrosse is one, like soccer, one of the faster growing sports. It is very popular in the mid-Atlantic states and so forth. And I believe correctly, Parks and Rec is anticipating that that could be used in the future for that type of activity.
The fields are getting stick.
That's where the term soccer ball is being grown.
The fields are being laid out where they can be, you can manage the turn, goals, if you use the fitter, any different sport, multiple different sports. It will also include a concession bathroom area, as well as off parking, for the facility and maintenance lawn and office.
Is that full-time staff? That skating park up there, see a lot of that too?
Far more than you would anticipate.
Is it like a park?
It is a skate park, yes. Most of what I've seen out there is skateboards. This is it, as well as a certain time.
Some of those parks, skateboard parks, consist of a platted area with portable jumps or ramps, etc. This is a bowl with those constructed in, and it has received significant recognition from those users who grade these facilities. Don't ask me why. It is, but they seem to be impressed by this.
It's graded, by the number of skin elbows and knees.
Anything else we can answer for you on any of the projects whatsoever?
Is there anything going on in the 4-H club at Long Pond?
There are no monies earmarked for this, but we do rent that facility.
You do have a little bit of maintenance in your town,
but you look after it too, also. It's one that's under your
management. It's really in parks. I'm sorry, it's under public resources. They maintain that. We've had to go in and replace the head wall that Mike in Public Works was involved in. And maybe do some dock work out here. Just general maintenance and upkeep on that for it.
I just appreciate you having Mike both. I can only imagine what effort has to go into figuring all this out. Touring buildings and figuring out what's broke, what needs to be fixed, what engineering and architecture firm, and so anyway, I appreciate it.
Okay. Thank you, John. Thank you very much.